लाइब्रेरी वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ITICT डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ AL कैटेगरी इन टुडे सेशन। सो AL2, देन आफ्टर द AL3-4, देन आफ्टर द AL5। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ AAL2 इन अ डिटेल। सो हियर यू जस्ट सी, बिकॉज ऑल ऑफ यू नो what do you mean by AL? AL means, that is known as the ATM adoption layer. So ATM adoption layer is generally divided into two sub layers. One, that is known as the segmentation and reassembly, and second one, that is known as the CS. CS means, that is the conversion sub layer. So here you just see ATM layer and AAL2. Currently I am talking about the AL2 because in AL1 already you know 48 byte payload is generally divided into 1 byte header and 47 byte payload, and then after 1 byte AL1 header is divided into the different two components. One, that is known as the SN. Second one, that is known as the SNP. SN supported the different parameters. SNP supported the different parameters. So here you just see in AAL2. So first of all, fully focus on this particular diagram. Here ATM is there, and in ATM already you know that is the 53 bytes for the cell. Out of the 53 bytes, 48 bytes belongs to payload and 5 bytes belongs to header. Then after, in AAL already you know that is divided into two sub layers, one SAR and one CS. What is the full form of SAR? Segmentation and reassembly, and CS means that is known as a conversion sub layer. So in SAR and CS for the AAL2, so here you just see from the higher layer directly transferring the 24 byte packet. In conversion sub layer, that is from this 24 byte is directly converted to 27 bytes. So how I converted to the 27 bytes? So 24 bytes from the payload means data, and 3 bytes header for the CS. Means in AAL2, conversion sublayer supported 3 byte header. In SAR, already you know that supported 1 byte header. So again I repeat, what is the main difference in AAL2? In AAL2, mainly two headers. One header for the CS that supported the 3 bytes, and one header for the SAR that supported the 1 byte. How? Here you just see 24 bytes from the higher layer, 24 plus 3 in a CS. Then after which, using the concatenation, it directly generating the 47 bytes. Then after it directly adds the header of 1 byte, it directly generating the 48 byte payload. This is the way you can circulate the data flow. So here you just see CS header supported the 3 byte, and all of you know 3 byte is equal to how many bits? 3 byte is equal to 24 bits. So here you just see in a CS header, so first one, that is known as a CID. So CID means what? That is known as a channel identifier. And channel identifier supported the 8 bits. Here in a CS header, I can directly allocate the 24 bits which using the different component. Out of the 24 bits, 8 bits belongs to CID, means that is the channel identifier. 6 bits for the LI. LI means that is the length indicator. 2 bits for the PPT. What is the meaning of PPT here? That is the packet payload type. That is known as the packet payload type. 3 bits for the UUI. That is the user to user indication. And 3 bits for the HEC. That is the header error control. Why we use the header error control? That is generally used for error correction as well as the error detection purpose. So CS header is generally divided into 5 components. 8 bits for the channel identifier, 6 bits for the length indicator, 2 bits for the packet payload type, 3 bits for the UUI, and 3 bits for the HEC. So here you just see the total. So 8 plus 6, 14, 14 plus 2, 16, 16 plus 3 19 and 19 plus 5, that is the 24. So this is the way you can directly calculate the CS header. After that, SAR header generally supported the 1 byte. 1 byte generally belongs to SF. So what is the meaning of SF here? That is known as the start field that directly allocated the 8 bits. So this is the diagram for the AAL2. Again, I repeat the flow: 24 byte from the higher layer, 24 plus 3 in a CS. Then after directly apply the concatenation and generating a 47 byte payload, and from that it directly passed to the ATM. So this is the way you can directly formulate this thing. After that, step by step execution of the AAL2 protocol. Here you just see. In the previous figure, already you know 24 bytes packets are received by the CS from the higher layer, and CS directly inserting a 3 byte header to each data packet. After that, whatever the packets are made available to SAR sub layer, which concatenate 27 bytes packet and add it byte header to form a standard ATM payload of 48 bytes. And then after, next point, AAL34. So up to this, whatever the discussion, that is totally related to AAL2 only. So must remember one thing: in AAL2, CS header supported the 3 bytes and SAR header supported the 1 byte. Here you just see, again the same procedure. Must remember one thing: ATM supported 48 plus 5, means that is the 53 bytes, 48 byte payload, 5 byte header, AAL34. Again divided into two components: one, that is the conversion sublayer; second one, that is known as the SAR, that is known as the segmentation and pre-assembly. So what's the logic behind that? What's the change in AAL34? So must remember one thing: in AAL34, conversion sublayer supported a header as well as the trailer, and SAR supported the header and trailer for each and every data packet. Here you just see, that is the difference in a diagram. SAR supported the header as well as the trailer. SAR supported the header as well as the trailer. So out of the 48 bytes, 2 bytes for the header, 2 bytes for the trailer, and 44 bytes for the payload. This is for the SAR calculation. Here you just see normal data, you can directly add the header as well as the trailer. So after that, the main concept in AAL34, which particular component that is the part of the CS header and CS trailer, SAR header and SAR trailer. So here you just see CS header. CS header allocated how many bits? CS header allocated how many bits? And CS trailer allocated how many bits? So here you just see, first one, CS header, first one, that is known as a CPI. What is the meaning of CPI here? Common part identifier. CPI means common part identifier. Second one, that is the BTEC. BTEC means that is the beginning tag. Third one, that is the BSI. That is known as the buffer allocation size. So CS header is divided into three components. CS trailer is again divided into three components. So 3 plus 3 means total 6 components. That's the part of CS. That's the part of conversion sublayer. Must remember this. Each and every name, that's the important one. At least you know the name. You can directly write for this particular name. So again I repeat, CS header, that is the CPI, that is the common part identifier. Second one, that is the BTEC, that is the beginning tag. Third one, that is known as the buffer allocation size. Fourth one, CS trailer. CS trailer supported the first one, that is the AL. What is the meaning of AL? AL means alignment. Then after ETAG, E tag means ending tag. Then after L, L means length. So this is the way you can directly bifurcate conversion sublayer into the header as well as the trailer. Then after, again the important point in AAL34, that is the SAR header and SAR trailer. So SAR header is generally divided into three parts. First one, that is known as the ST. What is the meaning of ST here? That is the segment type. that support is the 2 bit. Second one, that is the SN, that directly you know what is the meaning of SN, that is the sequence number. Third one, that is the MID. MID means multiplexing identifier. Then after the SAR trailer is divided into two parts. First one, that is the LI, means that is the length identifier. And last one, that is the CRC, that is the cyclic redundancy check, that is for the error detection as well as the error correction purpose. So this is the total diagram for the AL34. So already you know, first one, that is the AL, then after the AL1, then after the AL2, then after the AL34. So here, according to this diagram, total 12 components for the CS header, CS trailer, SAR header, SAR trailer. So here you just see one by one what is the meaning of that. CS layer header and trailer consist of 6 fields. So let's start with the first one, CPI, Common Path Identifier. So what is the meaning of that? It directly defines how the subsequent fields are to be interpreted. So that is known as the CPI. And the current value for the CPI, that is the 0. Means if any subsequent fields are to be interpreted, so you can directly put the value as a 1. So currently the value is present is 0. After that, begin tag. What is the meaning of begin tag? So value in this field is repeated in each cell to identify all the cells belonging to the same packet. Again I repeat, the value in this particular field is repeated for each cell to identify all the cells belonging to the same packet. So value is the same as the E-tag, beginning tag as well as the ending tag. After that, buffer allocation size. What is the meaning of that? Buffer allocation size is directly tell the receiver what size of buffer is needed for the coming data. So what's the buffer size for the incoming data, that is regarding the buffer allocation size. After that, alignment. So that is the one kind of alignment already you know. So this particular field is included to make the rest of the trailer, that's the 4 bytes long. After that, E tag, already you know, that supported the same as the B tag, and B tag and E tag that supported the same value. So that is about the concept of the CS header and trailer. Again I repeat the name, must remember, first one, that's the CPI, second one, that is the beginning tag, third one, that is the buffer allocation size, then after the alignment, then after the ending tag, after that, length. What is the meaning of length? So length of the data. So this particular field, it directly indicates the length of the data. So that's all about the CS header and trailer. Then after we talk about the SAR header and SAR trailer for the AAL34. So here you just see, first one, that is the ST. So what is the meaning of ST here? ST means segment type. It directly identifies the particular position of the segment in a message. Mainly 4 possibility. If you put the 00, so that's the indication of the beginning. If you put 01, that's the indication of the middle. If you put 00, so that's the indication of the end. And if you put 11, so that's the single segment message, that directly indicates the single segment message. So that's about the concept of the ST. After that, second one, that is the sequence number, already you know. Then after, the most important thing, that is the multiplexing identifier. So what is the meaning of multiplexing identifier here? So it directly identifies the different cells coming from the different data flow and multiplex on the same virtual connection. So that's why using the concept of the multiplexing identifier. Again I repeat, different it directly identifies the cell coming from the different data flow into a same virtual connection. Then after, length indicator, that is very simple. This will define the how much of the packet is data, not a padding. At that time, must remember one thing, not considering the padding part, only consider the data part. And after that, this is all about the concept of the AL34. And the last one, that's very simple, already you know, that is the CRC, that is the generally used for the error correction as well as the error detection purpose. So in today's session, mainly 2 points. First one, that is the AAL2. Second one, that is the AAL34. So here you just see, already you know this particular figure. Then after, the last point for the today's session, AAL5. Up to this, whatever the discussion regarding AAL2 and AAL34. Then after the last one for the AAL, that is the AAL5. Again, the same logic. ATM that supported the 48+5, that is the 53 byte cell structure. Out of the 53 bytes, 48 byte for the payload, 5 byte for the header. Then after, AAL5 is divided into two parts. One that is the conversion sublayer, one that is the SAR. So here you just see, in this, only one component, that is the CS trailer. So CS trailer is divided into four parts. First one, that is the UU. That is the user to user. Second one, that is the CPI. So that is the common part identifier. Third one, that is the L. L means that is the LAN. And fourth one, that is the CRC. That is the cyclic redundancy check, that is generally used for the error correction as well as the error detection. Here you just see in figure, data from the upper layer, whatever the data that is directly passed to the SAR sublayer. In a 48 byte, this 48 byte is directly divided into this. So this is the way you can directly calculate the component for the AAL5. Here you just see four fields, four trailer fields in this. First one, user to user. This field is directly used by the end user. Second one, common part identifier, already you know. Length, means indicate the length of the original data. And CRC, that is generally used for the error control purpose for the entire data unit. So then after the last point, disadvantages of ATM. AAL2, AAL34, AAL5, and then after the last point for the today's session, that is the disadvantages of ATM. So here you just see, first one, overhead of the cell header, because 5 bytes per cell, every time you put the 5 byte header for each and every cell, so one kind of overhead, that's the disadvantage. Second one, if you want to achieve the quality of service, so complex mechanisms are used to achieve quality of service. Third one, if any congestion in a network is there, it can directly cause the cell losses. So that is the main thing. And ATM switch is very expensive compared to LAN hardware. So ATM NIC is more expensive compared to Ethernet NIC. So this is again one kind of disadvantage of the ATM. So that's all about the today's session. In today's session, mainly again I repeat the topic name. First one, that is the AAL2, then after the AAL34, then after the AAL5, and last one, that is the disadvantage of ATM. Thank you for watching.